Bing Chat is now finally available to everyone to access and use, so no more wait lists. There still is a small hoop to jump through though, so in this video, I'll show you how to use Bing Chat along with a quick Bing Chat tour and demo. One great thing about the new version of the new Bing Chat is it now uses ChatGPT-4 engine, and you can watch this video here to learn more about just how groundbreaking ChatGPT-4 is. So now let's learn how to access Bing Chat AI. So to try out Bing Chat, just head over to bing.com and put in any question. Say ChatGPT-4 is now big news. And hey, what's that? Try the new Bing today. This message pops up. You now have access to the new Bing. Start exploring in Edge. Okay, so I need to install Edge browser. So hey, let's just tap explore and see what happens. It says chat mode is only available when you have access to the new Bing. We already know that, but unlock conversational search on Microsoft Edge. So that's what it's telling us to do. I'm gonna give it a go. I've got Mac OS, so I'm gonna download Microsoft Edge to use Bing Chat AI. This is good to see that they've optimized for both chips. I've got the Apple chip with a brand new MacBook Pro. All right, so I'll go ahead and accept and download. Let's just wait for that to download. Great, let's learn how to install and use Microsoft Edge. So just go ahead and double click that. It'll be the same for if you're using a PC. Pretty standard install, put in your password, install the software. I've never used Microsoft Edge before, so I'm looking forward to seeing how it actually looks. It's actually attracted a lot of users recently now that ChatGPT-4 and Bing AI is now ready to use. Wow, here it is, Microsoft Edge. All right, I don't really want to read any of this stuff now. Complete the setup, fine with that. Okay, do I want to sign in for now? Hey, let's continue without signing in and see if I can use the new Bing Chat. More info screens. Here we go, this is what I want to see. Introducing the new Bing, your AI-powered co-pilot for the web. Microsoft Edge is the best browser for the new Bing experiences. Let's go ahead and ask it some real questions. It's saying here I can join the waitlist, but we already know what happens when we do that. But as you saw before, we should now be able to use it. Skipping through all of this stuff, I don't care about it whatsoever. I just want to start browsing. Let's do a search on ChatGPT-4 release. Okay, at this point, I would have expected to see something to do with Bing Chat right about here. So it leads me to think that maybe I need to sign in.
And that is definitely the case. You need to have a Microsoft account to access and use the new Bing Chat inside Microsoft Edge browser. Watch this video here to see the process of signing up for a Microsoft account.
I've already got an account, so I'll just sign in with my username, and the way I log in is via sending a code to my email, so I'll do it via that method. Okay, now it says I have access to the new Bing, so I'll start using that now. Explore. And this is what I've been looking for. So here is the new Bing Chat interface. We've got a few example questions, and you've got the conversation style, which you can choose between being more creative, balanced, or precise. So we'll start with balanced for now, and let's type in a prompt. I'm interested in seeing this movie, so let's find out a little bit about it. You can see it's a little bit slow, and let's see about its knowledge of John Wick 4, even though it hasn't been released in Australia yet. You can see here that it's pulled a quote from another website, so let's make it create something of its own. While it thinks and does its thing, you can see you've got the option to stop responding here. There you go, so it's done it in its own words there. Let's try again, but triple the length of the response. There you go, it's giving a little bit more background into the movie. Now you see some numbers developing here. We've got 3 of 15. So what Bing Chat has implemented is limiting the number of chats per session to 15, and supposedly at this point, limiting the number of chats per day to 150.
So that stops people from abusing the new Bing Chat AI system and makes it so that it doesn't flood and overload the server like it did with ChatGPT. So I do support this move.
Finishing off with a couple more features of the new Bing Chat, and anytime we can just tap new topic, which will wipe all the info we had up there before, and then we can type in another search query. So you can see here that we're back to 1 of 15. So this is considered a new session. So you basically got 15 conversation threads of an initial prompt before it will cap you out at 15. And so that's a good summary of what's happening with ChatGPT-4. One great thing about the new Bing Chat is you can see it's got numbers here. So these are actually references to web pages that you can access that shows where it's pulling its information from. So that might be useful if you want to find out some more information regarding the query that you had.
From here, we can click any follow-up questions that we may have. And if we scroll down even further, we come back into the familiar looking search screen. And we can simply roll back up to go back to the Bing chat.
Now that you know how to access and use the new Bing chat without the waitlist, watch this video next to learn how Microsoft's Bing chat compares to Google's AI chat offering, Google Bard. So tap that now and I'll see you there.